Hello, my miracles. It is coffee and crime. So like I always say, grab your coffee. We're going to talk some crime and we're going to jump right into it. Marion Parker was born on October 11th, 1915. Her father, Perry Parker, was a prominent banker in Los Angeles. At the age of 12 years old, Marion was attending Mount Vernon Junior High School in a section of Los Angeles. Enter William Hickman. Posing as an employee of the bank where her father worked, he told the school that Perry Parker had been seriously injured in an accident and was asking for his daughter. William did not know that Marion had a twin sister and didn't even know either of the sisters' names. However, Marion was turned over to him. It was stated later that William had a sincerity about him, so the school did not see any reason why he would have evil intentions toward the little girl. The next day, William sent the first of three ransom notes to the Parkers' home. He demanded $1,500 in $20 gold certificates. William would sign the ransom notes in names such as Fate, Death, and the Fox. The first ransom drop had failed due to William seeing the police in the area. The next ransom drop, Marion's father arrived alone with the money. He handed over the money to William, who was sitting in his car. Perry Parker was able to see his daughter in the passenger seat. She was concealed up to her neck by clothing and was unable to move. As soon as William had his hands on the money, he took off. William pushed Marion out of the car at the end of the street. She had been dead for about 12 hours. Marion's arms and legs had been cut off and her eyes were being held open by wires. On December 18th, her arms and legs were found wrapped in newspaper. A week after Marion's murder, William was arrested in Oregon. He confessed to the kidnap and murder of Marion. William would state that he had no intention of killing Marion, yet did so because she knew who he was and because he was a former employee of her father's. William, after killing Marion, realized that Perry Parker would want to see his daughter before paying the ransom, so he attempted to reconstruct and disguise Marion's body so that she appeared to be alive. William Hickman was one of the first defendants to use California's new law that allowed pleas of not guilty by reason of insanity. On October 19, 1928, William Hickman was hanged on the gallows in San Quentin Prison. So I hope you enjoyed this short yet interesting coffee and crime episode for this week. If you did, click that like button. And if you are not yet a miracle and want to be, click that subscribe button. Watch a miracle happen.